Everyone, welcome back to my channel. It is day 13 of 20 of Confessions of a Paper Addict's 20 Days of Cut Files, and today's theme is stars, and I am doing a two-page layout of our trip to Splitsville, which is a bowling alley in Disney Springs in Orlando, Florida. And I am digging deep into my stash for this one. These are some papers from Scrap and Sports and More that is no longer in business. Years and years ago, I designed for this company, and I still have a ton of their papers because I still absolutely love them. And so I am using the front and the back side for my layout, as well as this ginormous bowling ball. It's an emblem, like an album cover. And I just think it really adds a lot because I have my big bowling ball on one side and my pins on the other. And so that's going to be the base for my layout. Now I have some pictures that I already cut down that are 4x6, and I'm just going to kind of put those through the middle and add in my clusters and my titles. And so for this, I use the bowling cut file from Confessions of a Paper Addict, and I just absolutely love them. I went ahead and backed them with some white cardstock, and now I am just using some shapes. I have some diamond shapes that are kind of a bowling feel to them. I feel like sometimes when you see bowling alleys, they have these diamonds, and so I'm going to put those behind my cut files. And then I'm going to also add in some stickers and some stars, and really add a lot of embellishments to this layout, because obviously there's a few photos, but also not a lot of elements on the base page other than the bowling ball and the bowling pin. Now, if you're not into making a whole lot of embellishments, you really wouldn't have to do a whole lot. If this is something simple that you wanted to do, that would totally be fine as well. You could just sort of leave it as is, maybe add some journaling. But if you've watched any of my videos, I definitely have a more is more kind of feel for that for my layouts, and so I am going to add a few of those. So originally I thought I was going to put that strike up there at the top, which would have been fine because it sort of balanced out my bowling title, but I'm going to go ahead and put that down on the bowling pins because I think that really is obvious that it's getting ready to be a strike. And so yeah. Now looking at it, I actually could have also put that bowling title up to the top left, just so that I kind of have a diagonal going with my title and subtitle, but I am going to embellish pretty heavily up there, so I think it's going to work out just fine. So I am going to kind of make a triangle kind of embellishment cluster, and so you'll be able to kind of see that visual triangle hopefully when I'm all finished. So I'm kind of going off the page with some of this cardstock diamonds, and I'm going to add some stars there, and I'm going to add a few down at the bottom as well, just to kind of carry that over and across my page. So I'm taking similar elements that I have and just pulling that up. Now, the one thing I will say is there were not a lot of colors in my pictures, which was nice because it allowed me to have a little bit more freedom with the overall design. I could add in the colors that I wanted without necessarily having to go by all of those colors. Now, there's some green and some pink, which you'll see some of coming through on my embellishment clusters, but for the most part, it's going to be kind of traditional Disney colors, the red, yellow, and black. So now I'm just going to go ahead and continue to build up those clusters. And of course, because that is our prompt, I got to get those stars on there. So I'm going to add those stars as well. Now, speaking of digging deeply into my stash, I also have this awesome sticker sheet from Paper House, and I'm going to add in those stickers as well. I'm not even sure when I got this sticker sheet, but I really love that it had a lot of the elements that I could add into my clusters to bring out that bowling theme without really overpowering things. I love that it sort of points to things. There's those kind of marquee signs, and it worked out really well. So we're obviously 13 days in now to having cut files every day, so I'm hoping that you're getting an opportunity to watch those videos and see sort of some varieties of ways that you can use cut files. You can use them just here, like an everyday title. You can use them as backgrounds. I think I've shown you some ways to add some mixed media to it. So, yeah, I hope that you're having fun and getting a lot of inspiration, and of course, following some of the other YouTubers as they play along with cut files as well. So, also, if you did not recognize that, they are running a 25% off cut file sale at Confessions of a Paper Addict in their Etsy store, and they have literally over 1,000, and they have some really wonderful cut files. So if you're inspired and you want to try some of these out, I would definitely encourage you to hop over to that Etsy store and catch these files while they're on sale, because it's really an inexpensive way to add interest to your pages. So here I have a bunch of just punched out stars, and then I have some chipboard stars that I am going to add just for a little bit of visual interest. These are from Studio Calico, and as you can see, the stars and the stickers are sort of bringing out some color in what would normally have been a very colorless, really, layout. And if you have never been to Splitsville at Disney Springs, it's just so much fun to go there. We only went for a couple of games because I think we were waiting on something else, or maybe a dinner reservation or something, but it's just a great time. Now, one thing I did sneak in on you as well, because there's sort of that wood floor element, I wanted to add a few wood pieces. So I have a couple of wooden Mickey heads. I think it's always fun to dig into your wood veneer stash if you have any. I personally have quite a bit in my stash that I would love to continue to use up. This has certainly been a layout that I have gotten to use up a bunch of my stash, which has been nice. And so I hope that it was inspiring to you as well. If you like my video, I would love if you would hit that like button. And if you're not yet a subscriber, of course, hit that subscribe button and come check out the channel, as we have a lot of fun things to share in the coming weeks. So have a wonderful day, everyone. Enjoy the close-ups, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.